Air felt a little colder today thanks to some breezy winds. Temperatures didn't change a ton, but the wind chills were a little harsher, down into the teens as of right now. The wind is starting to die down, so that'll help us out going into this evening. Currently 29, feels like 19 with the wind chill. Still seeing some breezy winds in some spots, generally between 10 and 15 miles per hour. But we're starting to see those winds calm down in certain areas, so we'll continue to watch the winds drop. However, temperatures are still dropping, so the wind chill is going to be a little harsh later tonight, down into the single digits right around midnight, and then climbing as we go back into tomorrow morning, expecting to see warmer conditions throughout much of the day, as we do have some milder temperatures right around the corner. This will be very warm compared to the cold later this week, but in the meantime, we are in for a bit of a brisk night. Increasing clouds, temperatures a little warmer, and the wind's a little lighter, so again, those wind chills won't be quite as harsh as what we saw earlier on this morning, but still, looking at some chilly conditions at times. Then we get into tomorrow afternoon, milder temperatures on the way, 36 for a high temperature under a cloudy sky. Our focus then turns towards the snow showers starting up in the evening. Generally, we're looking at lighter amounts with this particular storm, but some spots in Illinois maybe see some heavy snowfall out of this. On satellite and radar, we're watching two areas right now, one near Montana, the other near New Mexico. These two areas of low pressure will end up merging over the Midwest, and because we're kind of right in between these two, we get squeezed into seeing some heavier snow showers, but it looks like a lot of that's going to stay just to our south. So as these two lows come on in, snow showers are the results for tomorrow evening through Thursday morning. The National Weather Service issued winter weather advisory south of I-80 today, up to 6 inches possible in the areas highlighted in purple, and they are considering extending that into the city of Chicago if we see enough snowfall start up into tomorrow evening. Right now, though, we're on the northern fringes of this. We should be out of the brunt of the storm with some lighter amounts of snow, but keep in mind, still may see some slippery roads tomorrow night through Thursday morning. Here's future track, and the snow starts up. By the time we get to the evening hours, you can see 5 o'clock right along I-88 is where the snow shower activity is. Note the darker blue south of I-80. This is where, again, the brunt of that storm is going to pass. We head into later Wednesday evening and Wednesday night. You can see snowfall breaking out across the rest of the state line. Lighter amounts expected after midnight. So heading into Thursday morning, the snow will taper off to just flurry activity, but it may last past sunrise. So because we are looking at this storm to last a while, that's what's going to cause the snow to pile up, even though we generally are looking at some pretty light amounts, 1 to 3 inches possible. Heavier as you go southeastward, you can see as you get closer towards LaSalle and Chicago, 3 to 6 inches likely, and then dropping off more to the northwest with this particular storm. So keep in mind, even with lighter amounts, still could see some slick roads into Thursday morning. Then starting Thursday morning and lasting through a Thursday night, temperatures drop a ton. We go from 16 in the morning to 8 by Thursday evening, minus 7 by Thursday night, our coldest temperatures since last year. It's been a mild winter, so we haven't had many of these harsher values. Wind chill down to minus 20 at times Thursday night. We get into Valentine's Day. We are looking at the wind chill staying below zero with high temperatures in the low teens, and that could result in some ice jams. That could lead to some flooding on the Rock River, so we will be watching this closely, all due to the cold air causing a lot of ice development. By the weekend, close to 40 with a chance for some rain showers in the long-term forecast. James and Kristen.
Thanks.
Baseball is